In Tehran, the head of Karroubi's security team was severely beaten on Thursday, and he remains in a coma. The site blames the assault on members of the Basij militia. They support the supreme leader, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei. The attack comes as Iran stages Quds Day. Now, it's an annual day of anti-Israeli rallies. For more, let's go over live to Reza Sayah. He's monitoring the situation from Pakistan. Hey there, Reza. What are you hearing about what's going on now?
Zain, large crowds gathering in Tehran at this hour, as well as other cities throughout Iran to commemorate Quds Day or Jerusalem Day. This is the one day out of the year when Iran and other Muslim countries hold rallies to show their solidarity with the Palestinian cause. We're monitoring Iranian state-run TV. You're looking at Friday prayers now, where I believe President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad is delivering his speech for Quds Day. We've seen large crowds in cities like Tehran, Kerman, Mashhad. We've seen people holding up death to Israel signs, death to America signs, which is par for the course for this rally every year. Of course, Iran sees itself as a leader in the Palestinian fight against Israel, and that's precisely why Iran has won a lot of support outside of the country and the Arab streets. This is a big rally for them. Now, last year, this rally did not go as the government planned because the Green Movement, Iran's opposition movement, hijacked it. They came out in mass and turned it into an anti-government rally, Zain. They don't want to repeat performance this year, so we're getting word from witnesses that streets are lined with thousands of security forces. They've set up checkpoints, searching people. So far, we haven't seen an overt sign of opposition supporters out. And again, we're monitoring the situation. President Ahmadinejad delivering his speech at Friday prayer, Zain.
So what happened to the opposition as a movement?
Well, one analyst we spoke to described the opposition movement as hibernating. We certainly haven't seen them come out in mass over the past 8 months, and that has a lot to do with the brutal crackdown by the Iranian government and its security forces. But clearly, the governments are still very much concerned about this opposition movement. They've used different tactics to suppress them, clearly. They've tried to intimidate some of the figures. One of those figures is Mehdi Karroubi, the former presidential candidate, the reformist cleric. He had plans to attend this rally today, but we spoke to his family, and they told us for the past 5 days that dozens of members of the pro-government militia, the Basij, have surrounded his house, attacking Mr. Karroubi's house. We spoke to Mr. Karroubi's son late last night. Here's how he described the situation.
Absolutely, they came inside of the house, destroyed some part of the house, and my dad's flat also is okay right now, but we don't know about the future.
Did they try to attack Mr. Karroubi himself? Did they try to attack him?
That's right. They wanted, and they said, they are shouting and said, you want to do that, you want to kill him.
Where is your father? Was he injured?
No, my father is inside of the palace, and the people asked him if he leaves, and I'm not going anywhere. I'm ready to sacrifice myself. I believe on my way, and I'm not go anywhere.
Have the police tried to stop them?
No, unfortunately. And 2 hours ago, when they started to attack the house, they called the police. Nobody came.
We just spoke with Mr. Karroubi's son an hour ago, and he says the crowds are still there. That's why he's decided not to attend these rallies. He says it's much too dangerous. We're going to keep our eye on things for the next few hours, Zain.
Thanks a lot, Reza.